Okay, guys, so one of our very favourite guests to ever have on Guitar Interactive is joining us once again. The man whose name is on the guitar, Paul Reed Smith. How are you doing?
I'm good, thanks for having me again. Now, it wasn't that long ago we were together.
Well, that's it. I was just thinking, look, when
did you bring me a bottle of Octomore or something?
We did. I can just about remember that interview. I think as soon as the fumes started to hit, it was like, right, we need to wrap this up.
All right, so for everybody out there, Octomore is an extraordinary single malt that you can get, and I don't like it. I love it. It's delicious.
It really was quite something. It really is amazing. Now, the last time we saw you, okay, behind the scenes, we kind of knew this was coming, all right? We know that this has been in the works for a little while.
None of it got leaked. Come on.
Well, maybe we were just, privy to
this information. This is the most leaked thing that ever happened.
Why in particular did it take so long for this guitar?
We retooled everything. We retooled the tuning pegs, the nut, the neck, the headstock shape, the neck joint, the body shape, the pickguard shape, the entire bridge, which was saddles, front screws, plate, and block. We retooled the knobs, switch tip, the jack plate, the birds, everything. It's all been retooled. There's not a part on this guitar that fits on other guitars, except I think you can buy these screws on our website, and I think these pickups will fit in other guitars. But pretty much none of the rest of it really fits.
Obviously, everything that's on the guitar is there for a reason. You want to talk us through some of the design sort of aspects that are unique just to this model?
These are vintage peg.
Oh. Oh. Cut.
Nah, don't cut. It didn't ding it. Which is really good.
That's the root test.
It's really good. Yeah. So these are vintage pegs with retooled lightweight tips on them, buttons, and then we put our locks down through it. Mm-hmm. It's a angled headstock so that all the strings have the exact same angle over the nut. Some of these six on a side guitars, every string has a different angle, which changes the tone. We wanted that to be even and stay in tune with the arm. We put the truss rod adjustment up here instead of down here. It's a double action rod. We retooled this neck shape, which I adore. It's got a 25.5-inch scale and a 7.25-inch radius, which I found very interesting for the internet's response, because they were like, well, you can play chords on 7.25, but you can't play solos. I'm sorry, I thought Sultans of Swing sounded good. I thought Machine Gun sounded good. I thought the Stevie Ray Vaughan stuff sounded good. There was a lot of, John Mayer stuff.
Yeah.
If the guitar is set up well and the frets are leveled well, hear it buzzing out, and the action's quite low on the guitar. Yeah. We retooled the pickups. They're called 635s, which stands for 63.5, in between 63 and 64.
Interesting. Okay. I mean, something to notice on the pickups there that's a little bit different from Mastra is that the pole pieces seem to be
they're staggered for modern strings.
Right.
They're not staggered for a wound G. Mm. We retooled the way in which we did the electronics. There wasn't a thing on here we didn't retool. And look, we made the string spacing ever so slightly smaller, because some of these old guitars, the strings are literally hanging off the side of the neck, which I don't think is cool. Mm-hmm. We got the size of this right. Look, John, what do you want? He wants a guitar to wear on a strap and sit down and feel the same so he can play without looking.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we made a lot of prototypes. Sounds good.
It definitely sounds like the real deal, and obviously I've had a little bit of a chance to have a play with it as well, and it's just a fantastic instrument.
I mean, you have an old bastard vintage guitar, 63 body, 64 neck. I'll never forget that.
Yeah, that's it. I'll have to.
To me, that's a 63.5, 635. Sorry. The thing about these old guitars, very often the treble pickup's nothing but an ice pick, but this one. Thank you. we didn't put different pickups in each position. We didn't wind them differently. They're all exactly the same pickup.
Oh, wow, okay, right.
But this one's magnetically out of phase so that the in-between sounds are hum canceling. Mm-hmm. So we're happy with it.
I think at this point, you know, obviously there's been a lot of chat about the guitar just in the last couple of weeks, and really people need to get their hands on this instrument.
Well, because... As John Mayer said, there was a lot of noise when they started this Dead & Company thing, because John was playing guitar. He says, but I was at rehearsals, I knew what it sounded like. Mm. And he was at, he knew at rehearsals around this guitar sound. You know what's interesting? Let me plug the other one in,
okay,
just so that you can hear it's not an accident, right? Not exactly the same sound, but those are the same pickups. No matter what mic you put on Barbra Streisand, she's not going to sound like Paul Rogers. That isn't going to happen. But you can put the same mic in front of them.
I take it this is an older body on both?
It's an older body.
Is that something you've used in the past?
Yeah, we've used it many times.
Right.
We used to put older bodies on the backs of CEs. We've been using older on and off for a long time. It's just that we made a DC-3, which sounded very similar to this. And I like the DC-3 pickups a lot. But to me, this is even more a step in that direction. Mm-hmm. And to me, it would be nice that somebody for this kind of money can pick up a guitar that, you know, this guitar, it's got to sound pretty close to your guitar, if not as good in some ways. You know, I don't know what your guitar sounds like, but I know enough about how the parts are made to be able to give a guess at how it sounds.
Yeah, well, the thing that really stands out for me is when I'm playing it compared to a modern Strat you would get from a couple of different companies, the bridge pickup can be particularly kind of ice picky, you know, it can be really, really aggressive, whereas mine's is very, very mellow. And that for me is oddly more of the Strat sound. But we've had this discussion in the past as well about Les Paul pickups and what you've done with the pickups.
Right, well, you're using two trade names I can't use. But
sorry, yeah.
It's okay. but you're right.
You know,
and to me, this treble pickup. It's got a bell-like quality to it, but it doesn't sound like ice pick.
No.
As John says, the treble has bass and the bass has treble. If it was me, it was just me. Treble and bass pickup. What's weird about this is I've never liked the middle pickup on this, but I like this. That's pretty good, right?
Definitely.
Tune on all three pickups. I don't know. I like the way the guitar sounds. It sounds musical to me, and I'm enjoying playing it. And everybody on the internet is going to have an opinion until they get their hands on them, and then their opinion changed somewhat.
Well, I think that is quite interesting. I wanted to bring that up because I don't think I've ever seen such I don't know what's the word to use here. Help me, because what
keyboard courage?
Yeah, I mean there's
visceral nastiness. Yeah,
you know,
they called me the knife block at work. That's the big wooden thing in your kitchen you stick all the knives in. You know, look, 82% of the comments are their likes and dislikes are positive. 82% of the comments, you know, the written comments have been the other way around, but it's starting to change. And John put up a long 45-minute video explaining his thinking about all this, and I think that helped. And when people are getting their hands on them, almost all the reviews have been, well, people have had their hands on them, it's very positive. There's one on the internet where a guy has a 66 guitar, and he plugs it in at the end just to compare it. He goes, oh, God, it's a lot quieter. Not noise-wise, but volume-wise. He just didn't expect that.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to do that. You're going to compare this to your guitar.
Well, we're definitely going to compare it to this, and I think probably DC3 as well. We'll bring one in.
You have a DC3?
Nick does. He's got one.
You can't find those on the internet. Yeah, people really like
Well,
those.
I'll tell you what.
You can send me your DC3. I'll take it.
Well, I'll tell you what.
I guess I could make another one. I don't really need to.
Well, when it was purchased, it was a lot cheaper than what it'll cost after these hit the stores, because people will be looking for this and the old ones, you know. But
for the record, I like DC3s.
Yeah, of course. Well, why?
We got a chance to re-record Machine Gun, and the Hendrix, Experience Hendrix allowed us to do it. And I used a DC3 on it, and I thought it sounded lovely.
Mm, no, absolutely. It's an incredible, incredible instrument. The colors, a lot of people have been asking, what's next color-wise?
I think it's black.
That is
it. That
that's not what you called it on the website.
We do a white one and we do
it's
a
not called
silver
black
one.
On the website.
And now it's that.
What is it, onyx? Or
something? Yeah, something.
Are we able to talk a little bit about future colors?
No. Somebody's after me this morning about when the private stock one's coming. I said, let this thing breathe for a minute, will you? Just, you know, it's like a bunch of ravenous dogs going around looking for meat, you know. Yeah. It's okay. The part I like about the internet is that everybody's talking. Mm. The part I like is everybody's got an opinion, and it's a free world, and you're supposed to be entitled to your opinion, which is great. I don't like societies in which you're not entitled to your opinion. I like that part. I like that if I want to know something about some old German reverb, I can look it up online, and it'll tell me how it was made, what years it was made. I mean, it's like the greatest encyclopedia of all time. And you're communicating this that way, I assume. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think the internet's awesome. They call it keyboard courage at CNN, where somebody's, I said, Paul, or I said, somebody in their basement, in their underwear, you know, doing this thing.
Of course.
And they said, Paul, they're not wearing their underwear. And I was cracking up. The problem is, everybody on the internet has got 25 years experience, even the 14-year-old in Waco, Texas. So, look, I really like all this activity. It shows great interest in what's going on.
Yeah.
And that part, John loves and I love. I mean, there are websites you can go on and put my name in. And, yeah, I didn't like them very much. Yeah, you know, there are places we're not on the radar. There are places we are in the radar, but there's 160 people here from dealers all over Europe and the UK, and you know, as far away as Russia, and you know, and they're showing great interest. They're all here at a single guitar show. We're at a kind of a one instrument trade show in outside of London, and we're showing these guitars off and releasing them, and I think that the interest in guitar is at an all-time high. Mm. People have been trying to eulogize that rock and roll is going to be dead any day for years, but on the last time it was done in the Washington Post, that night, 20,000 people drove in their cars to go watch John Mayer play guitar solos with Dead & Company, and the next day at Sweetwater, another 20,000 people showed up to buy guitars. You know, it doesn't look dead to me.
No,
there's
no.
People here.
It seemed like it was very clickbait, that, you know.
Forget about all the keyboard courage. Mm. People having opinions where they haven't gotten their hands on the guitar. It's okay. Mm. What's not okay is long-term, if the market doesn't give us permission for this, which you've seen a lot of products come out and people don't buy it.
Yeah.
Market's got to give you permission for the guitar. If that doesn't happen, that would be tough for me. Mm-hmm. But I think we've done a good enough job tooling it up, and my orders are telling me we're going to be making a lot of these.
Yeah.
So thanks for coming.
No, thanks, Paul. It was a pleasure once again. We didn't get a chance to have a chat about the Stealth, but we're going to go out and cover that. The Stealth, the SE Stealth that you've got that's come out.
Right. They did that without me knowing about it.
Oh, right.
I'm teasing because basically my people know what they're doing. And they're doing a really good job spreading the word and doing new stuff. And my job at this show has been to try and get people to be comfortable with this thing that we've done, and I think that's gone well. Mm-hmm. I mean, all the dealers stood up and gave John Mayer took a picture of a high five, you know. The dealers really like these things, so that's okay with me.
Yeah, well,
look, don't stop having an opinion. I'm not trying to do that. I'm a guitar maker by trade. This is guitar making 808 to get it to sound that way, and to me, it was worth a try, and I think we did a good job.
Yeah, well, congratulations on it, Paul.
Thank
it's a
you.
Fantastic guitar.
Thanks
and we'll see you again soon, all right?
Thanks for having me. Hey, you guys, see there's someone back there.
There you go.
Perfect. Leave that in. See you guys. Bye-bye.